Hello, all of my Super Crash Bears. My name is Chronically Blue. Welcome back to part 6 of Crash Bandicoot XS, the Tiny Huge Adventure. Today we are going through and we are just cleaning up some of the areas that I messed up previously. As well as we're going to be getting a few extra gems, the last color gems actually. And that's more or less it. Just going through and cleaning up a lot of the levels because I missed boxes and I don't know where I missed them, but I just know that I missed them. So we are going through right now on a specific level that has a name, and it is a unique name. Let's just say it is if you have a career involving snow. You get hired for something involving snow. That's the nicest way we're going to put it. From what I recall, there are no secret boxes here. However, I did find one in an upcoming level where the green exclamation mark box was actually very well hidden. So I'll be very happy to show that to all y'all. As well as if I'm just getting the color gem or the gem root for one of the levels, and I'll be editing all the way up to that point just to make it easier on all of us. So here we are just avoiding the nitros as well as the yeti. Somewhat skillfully, I say as I die. But no, it's gonna be alright. If you made it through the first time, you can make it through the second time. However, I just wanted to go through and show it off because I don't know which boxes I missed. You probably don't know which boxes I missed. So there's more box leveling, as well as a lot of deaths. I died a lot here. But that's okay. These things, they happen. What can you do? But I am happy to say that by the time we finish this episode, there will only be three levels left. Three levels left to get the remaining gems. And then, because we've already gotten the crystals and the, technically the bad ending, once that happens, then we can just go through and start doing all the time relics. Which is going to be done very similarly to this, where it's going to be a lot of post. Unfortunately. Fortunately and unfortunately. Fortunately for you, because that means that you get to see nothing but the best. No deaths, nothing, just the absolute best. Because if you die during the relic run, you start at the back of the beginning. You have to do it all in one fell swoop. So that is helpful. Bad for me, because that just means that I get to do a lot of recording and editing, but it's worth it for all y'all. I appreciate all y'all, and I'm more than happy to do it. Plus, it's just kind of fun to see it, you know? As well as when we go through the relics, I'd be more than happy to give any additional tips I have for how to avoid stuff, get around stuff, the timing of stuff, this, that, and the other, sideways, up, downs, left dot, polka dot, put a dog in the pound. I don't know. Listen, I had a nap, which is why I have energy. Before that, No, I did not have the energy to record. So, thankfully I had an app, so I'm all good to go. And if I sound narcoleptic to you, I might be, but I have a job. I have a job that I like a lot, and I do go there. I work pretty well. At least I like to think so. The only part that is not so well is that I wake up really early in order to go to this job, and then once I get home it is like 4 p.m. and that's after 8.5 hours, so I'm like, okay, it's time for a nap. I'm sleepy. Need a nap. So here we have a bonus level, and they try to trick you on this one. I'd be more than happy to point that out. As we are bouncing over here, you see a little bit of red that was in the bottom left corner there for a second? Yeah, that one. Luckily, we didn't die, so it's not any lost time. But there is a TNT box right there, just to keep you on your toes. As well as I will say that I'm looking forward to a lot of things. I was thinking today, I know, dangerous, but I was thinking today, and I'm like, I think I know what I'm gonna do. I just have, like, some plans of stuff going in through my head and going on around, which I'm very excited for. So don't you worry, we are going to be... I'm going to be incorporating a bunch of stuff, and we are going to be having quite a great time. As well as if you hear any pounding or chopping, please ignore that. That is the bear clawing at my house trying to get inside. You know, that just kind of happens. I'm in a safe neighborhood, I think. You know, sometimes the bear tries to get inside, and I'm like, no, we don't have any bacon for you. And then the bear says that they're a vegetarian. I'm like, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't know you were a vegetarian. And they're like,
well, you didn't ask me.
I'm like, well, I'm sorry, you know, what do you want to eat?
I guess a salad or carrots.
Okay. Anything else? Do you want honey?
That is an offensive stereotype. Why would you say that?
And then the bear eats me alive. Anyway. Oh, wait a minute. What are we doing here? Oh, right. We missed the box gem here. That's it. Sorry. They reused the level last set, so it gets pretty easy for me to forget what level we're on. But that's alright. As well as, one thing that I should mention about this game is, if anyone sees you playing this game, they're probably not going to think it's a good game. Just because if you take, like, any random 5 seconds from the game that isn't, like, the jetpack levels, then they're gonna be like, wow, that's kind of disorienting. I don't know where I'm, I don't know where it'd be. And it's like, oh no, it'd be right here. I don't know if that's how you feel, but that's how I feel. Like, I played this game on a unique method that shall not be revealed, and I thought, wow, this is... No, I don't like this. And then, you know, I got it legitimately, I'm like, oh, hey, this is a lot more fun, actually. This is not bad. Listen, when you're in high school, everyone does dumb things in high school and middle school. Actually, yeah, it was mostly middle school for me is when I did the dumb stuff. But that didn't mean that didn't... Maybe I need a cup of coffee when I wake up. Maybe that's it. Please remember that box right there. It is going to try to trip you up. But yeah, so we are just going through. You are able to do the slam right there, and it'll drop you right on that platform, so it'll be there to catch you, so you don't have to worry about a thing. It is all good. Do be careful about those guys. They are going to bother us and make us regret being breathing. But there's easy ways in order to avoid them. If you see them, just immediately slide, and that way their arrow will go it will go above you and you will go under the arrow. That is what is most beneficial. So just try to get into like that knee-jerk reaction, and then you'll be alright. Now, it is in this level specifically that we do have the nitro box that is very well hidden. So well hidden that I missed it like 3 times, but we do find it. It takes a little bit of time. It is a little hard to find. You will need the double jump if you don't have that already. So this letting you know there. It's not up there. It's close. It's close. We're almost there. Don't you worry. As well as, I don't know if I mentioned, but I have a few side projects going on. And don't worry, they are not taking up all of my time. As you can tell, I'm still doing videos Monday through Friday. But I'm just part of a few side things, and once they get announced, I'll be more than happy to reveal them. This isn't an official update or an official announcement, which is why it's just kind of an afterthought while I'm let's playing, but once they are revealed, I'd be more than happy to make like a grand reveal thing to enlighten all y'all, because I'm enjoying it. I don't know the progress on them, but it's going alright. That is all the boxes here. You just have to go back now, and now we can hit that. And surprisingly enough, the bounty crate is still well within the time limit, which is very weird for me. I thought they had a much shorter time limit, but I guess not. So you don't have to worry about it. You don't have to let the anxiety ruin you. Just be like, oh yeah, look, this is fine. I can do this. Like, if you can spend like 5 minutes just trying and like waiting for it, then you'll be fine. Now, it is going to be up here, actually, I want to say. Yeah, I want to say it's going to be up there. No, it's right there. I don't know if you saw it, because we did run past it, but it was like there for a very split second and hidden. Now, thanks to the box tallies, we can confirm we do not have enough boxes. Hey, look, there it is. And there we go. So yeah, they really put that pretty well hidden, which I don't enjoy, but you know, they did it. You know, I can't stop them. Yeah, let me just go back, like, 20 years or so and make us that it's a lot easier. Here we have the airplane level. Just me shooting down all the boxes. Make sure to shoot the nitros. As long as you hit the balloons or the boxes, you're fine. They count. But I'm just looking forward to stuff. I have stuff planned. I'm ready. I just wish that I had. It'd be nice to just like take a video of me sneezing and then like that get like 50,000 views and people start commissioning me to sneeze. And I'm like, wow. Hey. Money. Thank you. Everything's going up by the paychecks, unfortunately. But you know, there's not a lot I can do about it. I can just go along with it. Just gotta move along like I know you will. I did see that there's a few performers coming up where I live, and I'm anxious to see some of them. One of them was Jeff Dunham. I don't know if I'm going to go see him. I just grew up watching him. So, I'm not too sure. I'd like to, but I know that I'd be going alone. The other one is, of course, Fluffy Gabriel Iglesias. I've been watching lots of his stuff for as long as I can remember. And it's good. It's good. If you haven't seen Fluffy yet, it's mostly PG. It's like rarely PG-13. You know, he drops a few F-bombs, but they're like after an hour into the show. So, yeah. You can just look up little clips and it's pretty good. In fact, one thing that happened was once we woke up, I went and started doing the dishes and my boyfriend was like, I want donuts. I'm like, ooh, let's go get donuts. So we went and got donuts, and I'm like, because you can smell it. If you don't know that little bit, I'll be more than happy to elaborate. Gabriel Iglesias was driving around, and he just exited the Krispy Kreme drive-thru. A cop pulled him over, and he couldn't contain himself. You know, the Krispy Kreme donuts were right there. He was starving. And so he opened it up, and he was getting real nasty with it. And the cop knocked on the window and said, do you know why I stopped you? And he said it was too easy, because you can smell it. And that every time I walk by a donut place now, I just think, because you can smell it. I've seen a lot more than just that little bit, but that's one of the few memorable ones. Along with a Hawaiian time, which means we get there when we get there. That's from his special Aloha Fluffy. But you didn't hear me to hear me talk about the stuff that I watch in my own time, or even about sneezing to make money. This has been a little off topic of an episode, but that's okay. And with these boxes here, it is not a lot to say here. Just make sure to get the boxes. If you miss one, don't live, and you will be responded to the most recent checkpoint. Now, I will say that for the time relic for these, it is going to be difficult, because I tried to do this as the time relic initially. It didn't work, because you have to stay alive. Some of the boxes, if they have the plus sign on it, then that gives you health. But the other ones, they just give you Wumpa Fruit or freeze time. So you gotta really, hedge your bets here. You gotta see what works. You gotta see, is it worth the anchor in the foot, or would I rather have a punch in the nose? You know what I mean? You gotta weigh out your options. And when there's a lot of options in 4 minutes, then, you know, it's quite a bit. I want to say the longest level in here, the time relic, is like 4.5 minutes. Which is, it's a little bit of time. Like, it's not horrendous. Like, it's a little bad, but it's not that bad. Right. But now we're going to go ahead and show off the next level, which is going to be the temple. Nope, not that one. We are going to do Temple of Doom later on, don't you worry. But we have another level coming up, actually. And it is in the final world. Pausing for dramatic effect here. Alright, so we're going to go and get the red gem, actually, here. Now, this one is a little hard to find, so if you have trouble finding it, that's okay. You just gotta. There's a lot of, like, things that cause it to be unique here. First off, do not hit that. Break the green box blocks. One, a two, give it a second, a three, jump over. There's going to be a row of nitros right there. That's why you gotta hit the green nitro box. Now, you gotta be really careful about how you time your jumps here, because you could mess up and no one wants to do that. Because then you just have to keep going through and re-getting everything. Which, you know, isn't fun. And also, there's no checkpoint boxes up ahead, so you just gotta make it the rest of the way without dying. So if you see me slowing down or just taking my sweet, sweet time, because it really took me like 10 attempts just to get that red gem and make it back up here. So we are just making sure that we go our time, you know? Like, we're not trying to redo this. We do it our way. It's our way or the highway. And guess what? We're low on gas, so it's our way. Okay, now that we have the red gem, we are going to go through to Ruined, and we are going to take the, is that Temple of Doom or Temple of Boom? I really can't tell. Anyway, we're gonna go to that one, don't worry. Alright, we are of course just going to go ahead and ignore the, all of it. It doesn't take me long in order to get here, so that's why I just kind of like put this in, because when you don't care about getting all the boxes, the level's over pretty quick, actually. And that's not even with using the Crash Dash. I know I keep bringing up the Crash Dash, and I haven't actually used it yet. To use the Crash Dash, you hold the L button, and you run. And it makes Crash run faster, and it is great for getting the time relics. However, for some of them, you don't really need it, or for some of them you can't use the Crash Dash at all, like the vehicle levels. Those are good examples to when you can't use them. So, you gotta figure out the best way. Just make sure to break as many time crates as possible, and you will either get the sapphire, the gold, or the platinum. You really want to get the gold. The platinum is just for bragging rights. But the sapphire doesn't contribute to the overall percentage. It's like, hey, you did the bare minimum. Congrats. You know? It's like, that's not really great. That's not what I'm here for. Now, this part is difficult. It is difficult. What you have to do is you have to be just very careful here. Like I was. As long as you have enough lives to cover you, you're fine. But what's going to happen is they put a lot of those shooting people on the sides here, and they will mess you up a lot. So make sure you have that knee-jerk reaction of ducking, sliding, one of the two, three of the four, eight of the six, because there's one right there. And yes, that one is blocking the gem. So you could go through this entire thing and completely miss the gem if you don't go to the right. Kind of stinks, but that's how it is. So yes, if you've been through this level like five times, and you're like, where's the gem? It's right there. I know it's apparent to me, but, you know, I can see why it wouldn't be apparent to most people. You know, it is a GBA game, so, you know, screen crunch is aplenty. But you have to be really careful here, because, again, if you die, you have to go back to go and get the gem, and no one wants to do that. Just make sure to use my little tactics here, where if you're on a arrow box, you spin in order to stop yourself from continuing being thrown upwards. We have to be very careful because there is another shooter here that is going to make our lives a little difficult. Yeah, if you just duck, you will miss it. Don't worry about it. And if you crawl, then they will actually bend down in order to shoot you on the ground. So make sure you don't abuse the bending tactic. The piranha plants you don't really have to worry about. They are very easy to manage here. Especially these little lizard guys. But the piranha plants in Crash 2, they are not easy to manage. You get too close to them and they take a big old bite out of you like they were a Krispy Kreme donut on sale. Speaking of which, I went to Krispy Kreme. I like Krispy Kreme. Who doesn't like Krispy Kreme? Well, I guess you have diabetes. You probably are not a big fan of it most of the time. But I do enjoy food. And my boyfriend actually had a great idea. We're going to have baked chicken covered in Takis. So there's two people out there. There's one of you that's like, that sounds disgusting. And there's the other part of you that's like, that sounds amazing. I like Takis. I just like the spices, the flavors. It gives me the heat without giving me the burn, if you know what I'm talking about. You know, the burn's upstairs. The burn's not downstairs. So that's how I like it. So to just It also has that crunch. I like that crunch. That crunch. Like, I prefer Nature Valley bars compared to the Chewy granola bars. I just like the crunch. It feels authentic. I like the crunch. But so that's why I'm a big fan of the food and such. Okay, so let's go ahead and see here. We have Jungle Day done. Shipwreck done. Temple of Doom done. Frosted Cream done. Justin Scream done. Ruin done. Chuck Attack done. Just Hangin' done. Rocket Racket done. Snow Crash done. Snow done. Nope. Sunken City done. Down the Hole done. Blimp the thing done. Nope. Dip, 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 dip. Yep, you know what? I was trying so hard there. But yes, we only have three levels left that we need to go into. It is Ace of Space, and it is a few other ones, but they're all space levels. But thank you all so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. I will see you all next time. Goodbye, my Super Crash Bears.